Mulberry genus Morus, grown as a penny needle tree or shrub, is an economically important plant used for sericulture, and it is a sole food plant for the domesticated silkworm Bombyx mori. Due to the presence of attractant, biting factor and swallowing factors, silkworm is attracted towards mulberry. Morus, which is widely distributed in Asia, Europe, North and South America and Africa, is cultivated exclusively in East, Central and South Asia for silk production. People of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Northeastern states and other parts of India much depend on sericulture activities where only mulberry and its varieties are grown for the purpose of silkworm rearing. Mulberry. Mulberry belongs to the kingdom Plantae, order Rosales, family Moraceae and genus Morus. Mulberry is swift growing when young, but soon becomes slow growing and rarely exceed 33 to 50 feet tall. The leaves are alternately arranged, simple, often lobed, more often lobed on juvenile shoots than on mature trees, and serrated on the margin. Depending on the species, the plant may be monoecious or dioecious. Multiple fruit with 2 to 3 centimeters long, and fruits when mature are white or green to pale yellow with pink edges. In most species, the fruits are red when ripened, turning dark purple to black and have a sweet flavor. The fruits of the white fruited cultivar of the white mulberry are green when young and white when ripe. Different mulberry species. The taxonomy of mulberry is highly confusing, complex and disputed. Over 150 names have been published, and different sources may cite different selections of accepted names. Only 10 to 16 are generally cited as being accepted by vast majority of botanical authorities. Morus classification is further complicated by widespread hybridization where hybrids are fertile. The history of Morus was first classified by Linnaeus in 1753. Seven species of the genus Morus were reported in the book entitled Species Plantarum. They are Morus alba, Morus nigra, Morus rubra, Morus tartarica, Morus indica, Morus pepperifera, and Morus tinctoria. Classification of the genus Morus by Koudzoumi. Koudzoumi in the year 1930 classified mulberry into two divisions, namely Dolichostylae with long pistil and Micromorus without pistil. Each of this division was further classified into two subdivisions based on the conditions of the stigma. These were pubescents with fine hairs on the stigma and papillosae with papillae on the stigma. Next, let me move on to classification made by Watta. Watta in 1950 reported two new species of Morus, namely Morus eshumurai Watta of Okushirito in Okokaido in 1936 and Morus Formosensis Otto of Taiwan in 1937. Between 1937 and 1942, Otto reported the identification of five varieties and two cultivated varieties of Morus astralis, one variety of Morus tilifolia, 14 varieties and three cultivated varieties of Morus bombicis, and one variety each of Morus bonicis and formosensis. Classification by Koudzoumota. Koudzoumota in the year 1972 made the classification on the basis of the condition of idioblasts of the leaves. He classified the idioblasts into four types according to the shape of the upper surface of the idioblast. The four different types are round and smooth upper surface, minute angular protrusion on the upper surface, blunt angular protrusion on the upper surface, and prominent angular protrusion on the upper surface. A large number of mulberry varieties belonging to Morus bombensis, Morus alba, Morus latifolia, Morus cagayame, Morus levigata, and Morus nigra were studied for these features. Classification based on biochemical characteristics. It is difficult to classify the species and varieties based on morphological characters alone. Therefore, various other methods are being applied to work out the affinity. Isozymes such as peroxidase, esterases, amylase, etc. of the plants are classified through electrophoresis. On the basis of difference in the pattern of electrophoresis, the affinity is worked out at the gene level. In mulberry and its varieties, isozymes of peroxidase, amylase, etc. and proteins are isolated from the leaves and bark of the branches. On the basis of electrophoresis pattern, the affinity among the varieties of mulberry to other plants was ascertained. Natural growing regions of mulberry can be broadly classified into following four continents. Eastern part of Asia, including Japan, Korea and China. Southeast Asia, consisting of Indonesia and Thailand. And Southwest region, comprising of Afghanistan, Iran and Armenia. Orient, consisting of countries Java and Sumatra. Southwest part of Africa, including Nigeria and Congo. Region between southern part and central parts of North America, western part of South America. Thus, natural distribution covers wide areas of the globe. The wild mulberry grows in all the continents excepting Europe and ranges between latitude 10 degree and 50 degree north. In view of such natural distribution, mulberry is considered as a plant suited for tropical and temperate regions. It is known that though mulberry was not present in Europe, but seems to have introduced from other regions. Morus alba, Morus nigra, Morus levigata were the main species which were introduced into Europe. Characteristics of plant belonging to the genus Morus. Plants belonging to the genus Morus are arbor or deciduous with scaly bark. The plants have latex and winter buds with scaly coverings. The leaves are broad and may be lobed or entire. The leaf margin is denticulate and the leaves are alternate. The petiole has pair of stipules at the base and leaves fall early. The flowers are usually unisexual and rarely bisexual. The small flowers collectively formed in the inflorescence. The inflorescence can be female or male, and when the female inflorescence matures, it gives rise to syncorp. The male inflorescence fall off early. On the basis of the presence of male and female flowers, the plants were classified as bisexual or unisexual. Cultivated varieties of mulberry. Kaurzomi, in an effort to avoid mixing up of terms, referred as species and varieties of mulberry. Among the varieties of mulberry, there is large number of hybrids. Since mulberry grows by forming large number of seedlings through vegetative propagation, even when the parent plant is a hybrid, it is possible to grow plants with identical features of the parent plant without any limitations. Therefore, when plants with excellent features are found from among the hybrids obtained through crossing, or excellent mutant plants obtained through natural mutation, it is possible to grow the clones by grafting, layering or cutting so as to establish the resulting varieties. Mulberry varieties from East and Southeast Asia. Following varieties are observed in South and East Asia, which include Morus atroporphyria, Morus bombicis, Morus cathayana, Morus indica, Morus japonica, Morus cagayame, Morus levigata, Morus latifolia, Morus libionensis, Morus macromora, Morus mangalica, Morus multicaulis, Morus notabilis, Morus serrata, Morus telifolia, Morus trilobo and Morus vitorium. Lot of deliberations or discussions are taking place in the international arena regarding mulberry biodiversity, and was debated in two international conferences, namely Convention on Biological Diversity, that is CBD, held at Rio de Janeiro in 1992, and Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, in Lipizig, Germany in 1996, where Global Action Plan for the Conservation of Plant Genetic Resources for Food and Agriculture was developed. The concept of biodiversity conservation and gene bank maintenance have gained great momentum in recent times, and issues related to access the plant genetic resources and its sustainable use, benefit sharing were discussed at the international fora. India has been recognized as one of the 12 mega diversity centers of the world and harboring 11.9% of the world flora. Mulberry is considered as advanced woody flowering plant with high biomass production and protein rich foliage, not only nurturing the entire sericulture industry in India and used exclusively in agroforestry and horticulture programs. The need for diversity is continuous because of fast changing at the global environment. The scarcity of the land and water will be the major constraint in future, and development of varieties suitable for different agroclimatic conditions are utmost important for sustainable development. Mulberry genetic resources at the global level. Mulberry is native to temperate Asia and North America. Presently, Morus grows in warm climatic zones between 50 degree north latitude and 10 degree south latitude, which includes Sino-Japanese region of the old world, and distributed in more than 29 countries or more. So far, about 150 species of genus Morus have been described, and presently 50% of them have been reduced as synonymous or varieties of the same species. Of late, Morus comprises of about 68 recognized species and distributed in different countries, mainly from Asian countries like Japan, China, Korea and Taiwan. Continental America is also rich in Morus species. Exploration of wild Morus species in crop improvement programs have been greatly thought, and major exploration activities in the centers of diversity were undertaken to collect wild species to supplement the genetic variability. Morus multicaulis species is widely used in many mulberry crop improvement programs in Japan, India and China. The potentiality of American species and the isolated Morus species from different countries like Africa, Middle East, Thailand, Indonesia for alien gene transfer should also be looked into for explanation. Mulberry genetic resources. Indian scenario. India is situated between 8 degree and 38 degree north longitude and 68 degrees to 97 degrees east latitude and exhibits wide variations in the altitude from sea level to the heights above vegetation limits in the Himalayas and extremely arid to semi-arid in northwestern plain. Proteologically very rich with about 15,000 botanical wealth and out of this about 4,900, that is 33%, are endemic, which belong to 141 genera and 47 families distributed over 15 agroclimatic zones. Great seri biodiversity exists in entire sub-Himalayan belt, northeastern regions, central plateau and Andaman and Nicobar Islands, which includes all the sericigenous insects and its host plants. Indian Gene Center is very rich in Morus species. Wild relatives of genus Morus are reported to occur in India in tropical and subtropical Himalayan belt from Indus to Arunachal Pradesh ascending to 1250 meters. Hooker 1885 and Brandis 1906 have reported the occurrence of four species of genus Morus, namely Morus alba, Morus indica, Morus levigata and Morus serrata. Parkinson 1923 reported the occurrence of Morus levigata from Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Congillal et al. 1923 enumerated three species from Assam and Northeast, namely Morus serrata, Morus levigata, Morus acidosa. Nair 1977 documented the occurrence of Morus serrata from Himalayan up to an altitude of 3300 meters. Rich Morus diversity also exists under both natural and managed habitats. Many foreign rulers introduced many exotic varieties in the Indian Gene Center. Besides, the introduced germplasm resources from different temperature and tropical countries, which are available in the research institutes, universities and state departments, are collected to enrich the mulberry gene bank. This unique heritage is serving the mankind since time immemorial. In India, efforts have been made to use primary gene pools constituted predominantly cultivars belonging to Morus indica and Morus alba to tailor the desired varieties. However, promising gene exists in the secondary and tertiary gene pool in the wild species can be utilized for gene transfer by applying biotechnological and molecular techniques. Realizing the importance of mulberry germplasm for sustainable development of sericulture in India, Central Sericultural Germplasm Resource Center, CSGRC, was established in India, which is presently holding 908 diverse mulberry germplasm accessions representing 26 countries belonging to 13 mulberry species in ex-situ field gene bank. Characterization and evaluation of 628 mulberry accessions have been identified. Biodiversity is very much inevitable for any crop improvement program, particularly mulberry. Endangered species in their habitats acquire great significance in conservation. plant breeders have greater range of genetic diversity is fundamental to the success of development process. Biodiversity conservation is an instrument that yields substantial local, national and global benefits. The unique heritage serving humankind since ages has to be protected and conserved for the present and posterity. Conservation of mulberry genetic resource. For sustainable development of sericulture in India, establishment of germplasm is need of the hour. In this context, Central Sericultural Germplasm Resource Center (CSGRC) was established in the year 1990 under the aegis of Central Silk Board. It is the important nodal agency for mulberry germplasm management in India and recognized as National Active Germplasm Site (NAGS) for mulberry by National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources (NBPGR) New Delhi. Survey, exploration and collection of mulberry genetic resources. Phytogeographical information is necessary for exploration and collection of natural genetic resources. Work on survey, exploration and collection of mulberry genetic resources was initiated. The main objective of exploration is to identify the areas where significant resources of Morus species occurred threatened with deforestation. Survey, exploration and collection of mulberry genetic resources were continued from 1993 onwards by CSGRC Vasoor. Mulberry germplasm is established by Central Silk Board from different countries are also collected to enrich the mulberry field gene bank. Uses of mulberry. The ripe fruit is edible and widely used in pies, tarts, wines and tea. The fruit of the black mulberry, native to Southeast Asia, and red mulberry, native to Eastern North America, have the strongest flavor. The fruits and leaves are sold in various forms as nutritional supplements. Unripe fruit and green parts of the plant have a wild sap that is intoxicating. Mulberry leaves, particularly those of white mulberry, are ecologically important as the sole food source of the silkworm, the pupa and cocoon of which is used to make silk. Anthocyanin are pigments which hold potential use as dietary modulators of mechanisms for various diseases and as natural food colorants. Due to increasing demand for food colorants, their significance in the food industry is increasing. Anthocyanins are responsible for the attractive colors of fresh food plants, producing colors such as orange, purple, black, and blue. They are water soluble and easily extractable. Mulberry, the sole food plant of silkworm, is grown in India since time immemorial. The distribution of mulberry is global, and different species are widely distributed throughout the length and breadth of the country. In addition to feeding silkworm, the leaves have greater potentiality for treating various ailments.